News of the track.
Tributes continue to pour in as Boyzone members flew Stephen Gately's
wife suddenly lost on holiday.
Thousands lined the streets of Dublin to pay tribute.
The phone rang and I got a call from Gerald Keane to say, Ronan, how are you? I said, how are you doing, Jerry? How's it going? I said, how are you? He says, I have some bad news. Stephen's passed away. And it was just, that was it. That's the call I got. And I went, immediately I thought, Stephen who, Jerry? Was my initial reaction. And my brain started clicking through Stephen's, I knew. Not Stephen Gately for one second. Other Stephen's. And I went, oh, right, Stephen who? And he said, Stephen Gately. It was a shutdown. It was a, you know, it's the band was finished as we knew it at the time. It was over.
The phone rang and it was Ro, and obviously he was very emotional at the end of the phone. And he said, Shino. He said, Steve's gone. And I didn't really, I heard him and I said, what do you mean? And he goes, Shino, Steve's dead. Instantly, I went, okay, okay, bud, calm down.
You know, it's been just chaos ever since. I've been in a state of numbness, is the only thing I can say.
What a fucking day.
I was in a rut. I could not figure it out. The hurt, the pain that I felt so sore.
It's frightening. How something like that can turn your world upside down dramatically, like so dramatically. I don't sleep like I used to sleep. I don't think like I used to think anymore. I don't think about life like I used to think about life. It's totally changed, and I know the lads feel the same.
Everything seems blurred and weird and uncomprehendable, and, you know, just this vortex going on in your mind, you know?
I still, you know, think he's going to walk in the room. But not for one second have I realised he's gone.
I don't actually deal with death. I don't talk about it. I don't deal with emotion. I don't deal with any of that. I wouldn't be the guy to ask, how are you feeling? Because I don't want to be asked how I'm feeling.
Hello, everybody.
Alright,
Roy.
Let me try and get the Rosaline. Hey, you. Still nice and tight.
Thanks,
buddy. Thanks for the work out. What are you doing? You alright?
You
okay?
Yes.
I don't know how to take it, lads. I don't know how to take it, deal with it.
Deal with what?
Well, all of it. The paper, everything.
I can't do it. I don't think I should go tonight.
No, we have to go tonight because we're going tonight for steel.
I know. I have a lot of emotion flying all over the place.
I know, pal, I know.
The memorial was too close to the actual funeral for me, because all the memorial done for me was bring me back to the funeral again. And, you know, it was a very upsetting time. It still is a very upsetting time. And you have to try and move forward and deal with it and figure out how you can function in your life again after something like that happens.
We're going because the four of us are going to stand together for Steel.
There's a lot of people made a lot of effort for Steel tonight.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
No, we appreciate that, and that's no problem.
I wasn't for a second giving out about the fact the memorial was on, and so many fantastic people paid their tribute to Stephen, and it was beautiful. But for me, it was just having to sit and endure memories of my friend that are always going to be there. I don't need to be reminded of them right there and then.
We have to do this tonight together, the four of us. We have to go for Steel. Out of respect, nothing else.
I saw Ronan pull the positive out of a negative of some of us who didn't want to go, and say, lads, you know what I mean, this isn't about us, it's not about, it's not our gig, fine, but we're not doing it for us, we're doing it for the support.
I just want it to be over. I don't want to go. Been through this already, I don't want to have to do it again. It's just like bringing up old ghosts or something, I don't know how to explain it. I don't want to do it. Gotta have to.
everything is happening very, very fast at the moment that it's very difficult to take anything in as to why we're doing it.
Andrew wanted to put this memorial together in London, so we have nothing to do with it. We are guests tonight, I guess, but it's just a bit odd that I'm coming here for Steo and I have nothing to do with it.
I guess we said our goodbyes to Steo and we all went back to our individual lives for a while, for a couple of weeks. And in that time, we started talking and texting and calling each other and saw each other here and there, and we'd go for dinners and stuff and hang out in each other's houses and start talking about it, and realised we have to make this record for him.
He was living for this album. He was, you know, he was very excited and buzzed by the album. So if we were to do it, look, we've nothing to lose by releasing the album except the fact that we'd have a nice tribute to Stephen and something that we'd always remember him by, apart from all the beautiful memories we have, I mean. And if it doesn't sell and if it's not successful, well, there's nothing lost, really.
And that's all it's been, and that's all it still is today, is making the record for him that the band were making as a five-piece. So we're finishing this album, we're going to put this album out, and then we decide. Then we see. We see what happens over the next few weeks and months.
I mean, honestly, with the amount of tracks we have now, we have so many great songs, many fantastic, brand new songs.
My attitude is, I want to come out of this meeting going, do you know what, it's not just about the three singles, it's about the best record we've ever made.
Yeah. I cross over quite a bit with Greg Wells on all of the tracks. Just looking at us, Shannon crosses over. I'd say we all probably do, Keith does as well. So there's a lot of us feeling the same way about a lot of songs.
And just one more, quite a few more on my list here, but there's one called I'm Right Here. Well, that's a title I have for it as well. Do you have it there?
What's
that
called?
Title?
I'm Right Here.
Have
you a number on it?
No.
I have no idea.
Well, I'll just play it here from this. I mean, it won't be
sounds are all there.
I knew what the songs were going to be, what in my heart and soul I believed what the album was going to sound like, but because we're this, in the state that we're in, that it's, you know, it's one for all and all for one, we all stand together and decide here. We went through that process, and if anybody stood up and said, no, I don't believe in that song, or what about this song, why isn't this up here, you know, why isn't this in the running, then that's what those meetings were for, so that everybody could be heard.
Mark Fox, he whittled down a few hundred tracks to, let's call it 30-odd that I had, and every one of them grabbed me as I listened, and every one of them got me excited. And there were some songs not on the album which I thought were absolutely amazing.
We're all very driven guys. And Ronan is, he wouldn't be as successful as he is were he not so determined, let's put it that way.
If we're gonna make footprints, and we have to be vicious, brutal, and
for the last 7-8 years, this is what I've done and what I've continued to do since the beginning of Boyzone. And I've kept my ear to the ground, I've paid attention, I've learnt, and I've worked hard at it.
Ronan does put himself under an awful lot of pressure, you know? I mean, like I said to you earlier on, the 8 years out of the business that we were gone, myself and the other lads, Ronan stayed in the business as a solo singer. And his education of those 8 years, what he learned over those 8 years is phenomenal. And when I saw that in the first rehearsals of the first Boyzone reunion tour, I was blown away by his knowledge and his understanding of the music and his understanding of how to direct the musicians and how to pull it all together.
I think this is the last one, actually.
Okay, because I'm just aware of time for everybody, and
hold your head up, this is the last one.
Okay.
He does it because he loves it, and he loves the business, and he does it very well, but you never hear him moaning.
So is it a democracy, or...?
An absolute democracy, 120%. This band, this album, has been put together by at the start, the five of us. And it'll be finished by the four of us.
Now, talk to the phone. God bless. See you, man. Take care. Thanks.
Thanks, man. All right. God bless. Hey,
I said, I mean, you know, lads, there's going to be a huge hole in the band. I said to the three of them. And I don't know how long it was after Steel passed. I said, there's a huge hole in the band now. and everybody has to up their game. All of us, if we want this to move forward.
Yeah, that's the line, that's the line. The line just before the whoa, whoa. What is that lyric? I was bloody right. I knew I was right. Just spoke to Don Mesco, and it's burn and fall is the line.
Burn and fall.
Burn and fall. Yeah. I was right, is my line, right. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of D-Day now. Album's out March 8th. It's the 10th of December. The lads have a serious job on their hands. We've got 10 more vocals to record between now and the end of next week. And
but we're up for it.
The boys are up for it. And it'll be interesting. Heads are down. Focus. Let's go. Didn't say anything during the night, did he?
I think maybe it might have been difficult in the early years for the youngest member of the band to be trying to help other people in the band or to be taking the reins in any way. And they're happy to, you know, let me do what I do. You know, let me take the reins. Let me, you know, step up to the plate when it's needed.
Boyzone worked principally because you had Ronan and Stephen at the forefront with the other guys playing a supporting role. And I struggled with that for years and years because I didn't feel as everybody feels, I suppose. I don't know how anybody can ever become completely settled with playing a supporting role. You know, everybody wants to be lead man in a movie one day.
The last one was good. The last one was good, the third. Yeah.
Yeah, we all battled with our roles in the band and who we were and who was doing this and who was doing that. Oh, we were kids, man. We were kids. We wanted things. That's what it is. It's selfishness. It's ego. I was 16 when I joined the band. I was only a baby when I came into this band. And I worked extremely hard in the 6 years to make Boyzone the best it could be. And I think at a time I probably felt a little bit resentful, maybe, that I didn't even realise how hard I had worked.
I know what's important in life now to me. And my younger, egotistical problems are not really what it's all about.
Mikey, what do you fancy doing?
Whatever falsettos you need for us.
Oh, yeah, the falsettos.
This is, you know, what fate has decided the story of Boyzone is to be. And I'll just, to the best of my ability, do that, you know. Make Stephen proud, make the boys proud. And this is the shape of things now. This is something that we, hard as it is, have to accept.
Let it go. Don't be scared to breathe again. It's all right. Close your eyes. And together we can feel what it's like.
I think we all felt pressure by standing into what we thought we had to fill a pair of shoes. We didn't realise that, lads, you are Boyzone, you still are who you are. Nobody has to fill anything. And I just think we initially got it wrong in the beginning by thinking, oh my God, I've got to sing a song, I've got to do this verse, I've got to do that verse. But also we were encouraged to do that because it gave us something to focus on.
You know, we're still gathering our thoughts and the album has, though we never expected it to be this way, it has acted and is acting as a therapy and a stability in a storm, really, to be honest with you.
So we've tried over the last few months to find a new sound and a new band and a new balance. You know, so other people have been, you know, trying to push other people in studio to get them out there and do lead vocals. And because if it was just me, if I just go in and, you know, without Steel and it's just me on the lead on a lot of the tracks, well, then it's my album. It's not Boyzone as it should be. There has to be one. So the lads have really stood up to the plate.
All right, who's doing the first pass?
Running?
You do.
Okay.
Ronan has to put a lot more work in than the rest of us because he predominantly is the lead singer in this band. So that means a lot more hours in the studio than the rest of us.
Great, bro. All right.
Magic.
There was a hunger for this album. We all went into that studio very, very hungry.
Yeah. That's right. Silly man, I don't even you're asleep with me.
Back to front then.
So, I don't know. I'm making the record and that's the only frame of mind I'm in. I'm not thinking about performing. Because I don't know what it's going to be like. I'm not ready for it.
Just arrived at a video shoot for Gave It All Away. Which I'm looking forward to hearing because Stephen's vocal should be on the first verse when we hear the song today. So it should be difficult, but I'm looking forward to hearing it as well.
Morning.
Morning.
How are we all doing?
Quite
well, right?
The best of you.
Just put the glasses on us so that nobody knows who she is.
Now you won't know her.
Let's go make some history.
Shooting a video for Gave It All Away was something I went in quite prepared for. And the concept of the video was literally writing the last letter to Theo.
I'm not going to focus on the words.
Yeah.
The only words I'll ever use in the video is the word dear and the word Theo. Everything else that you write, you fold it up, you put it in, you seal it, it's your view. No one will ever see that.
Roll play back.
You hear that?
The video came along and a ton of bricks.
Why?
Because it was really evident he wasn't there. Really evident for us all that he wasn't there.
How should I describe it?
It was just this huge hole. It just felt like, you know, this massive gap.
Go play back.
I was basically kind of saying to him, I'm sitting here on a cold floor, trying to think of words to say to you, don't know what to say to you, and I was having a laugh and a joke with him. And then I actually let my guard down.
I will learn to live before I die. Will learn to love and learn to try not to give it all away.
I think as soon as I let that guard down, for some reason, I listened to the lyrics, which I was just more concentrating on what I was doing in the video, but then I actually let that up and I listened to the lyrics and it hit home. And I felt just inside, I started to rattle inside, and I just could not be there any longer. I had to get up, I had to leave, I just had to get out.
That's hard. Do you know, one of the hardest things, when you start writing, the funny thing is, I kind of took my mind off lyrics and started writing, and then I almost started having a crack. You know? One of the hard things is, and I see it just got Duffy as well, when you actually seal the letter, you know, and you write, there's Leo, it's like a defining moment of, that's, it's over.
In the day of that video, it was weird. That's when the walls came tumbling in, really. It's hard to know what to say at the end of a day like that. But somehow we managed to get through it. It wasn't easy, very emotional at times. And a lot of fun though as well. A lot of good kind of memories and things went through our minds. A lot of happy memories of Steven. Can't believe it though, just can't believe it.
I guess Boyzone has had quite a few, I won't say false starts, but a few rebirths in the last few years. We have lives away from the band now, which is very important for the balance of all of this. When it was Boyzone, it's all we had. The first time around, it's all we had. So we ate, slept, breathed this is it. Now it works because we have something else to focus on and it's healthy. I'm lucky, I feel lucky that I have the opportunity to do it. I don't want to take it for granted.
I came down here and this was kind of the... This was the first bit of work, you know, I was to do. And that was in the diary. I was very apprehensive about leaving my comfort blanket of my family and the lads and coming down here. The lads said it would be a good idea, you know, work and focus. So I did, I came down. First few days were tough. Every interview that I was in asked me about Steo, and it brought it all up, all that raw emotion up again. But it was like therapy, and the more I talked about it, the more I started to deal with it.
Barney.
My life has changed in the form that I've been out there desperately trying to succeed as Keith Duffy, whether it be as an actor or on TV in some form or fashion, and to have some sort of a career that I'm enjoying and that I'm proud of.
Okay, rehearsal. Shh, shh, shh. Just quiet, please, for a minute. Shh, shh. Cool. And action.
All right, keep your hair on.
My loyalty and the unfinished business I have with Boyzone is something that I'm not going to, you know, wave goodbye to unless I have to. We're releasing this album out of respect for Stephen because he was very much a big part of putting it together in the first place. If it never sees the light of day or people don't want to buy it and it's not successful, so be it. We've all got our own individual projects going on that we'll just have to go back and do.
To be bold enough to think that Boyzone could actually get back in the form that it was before, meaning that we're busy promoting in Europe, in England, in the UK, whatever, Australia, and that we go on tour again and do all that. That's something that I dare not dream of right now because I don't know if that's going to happen.
Back to the day job.
Back to the day
what
job.
What is the day job now, though?
Well, the day job in my real world is music. It's always music, music, music. But at the moment, I'm the Iceman. I'm on thin ice. Dancing on ice on a personal level acted as a great distraction from the emotional impact after Stephen's death. It allowed me to be highly focused on something else.
But it seems everybody wants to be back to Boyzone. I mean, why does Ronan want to be in Boyzone?
Well, I think because we had 8 years apart, and not only personally did we realise what a wonderful thing it was to be part of Boyzone. But collectively as well, you know?
I would like to think that things get so big again that there's no room for anything else while we're doing it.
Right. So success is not just about success, it's about keeping the unit together.
That's what it is for me. It's about being together. I enjoy their company. I enjoy being with the lads. I love it. I love it.
What do you love about it?
I just love the camaraderie, the friendship, the brotherhood, the unit. That's us, the bubble.
I'm going to go over here now to Japspeed headquarters where the race car's been built. And all going well, she's probably the most powerful and quickest drift car in the world. And that's a lot to say. It didn't matter what race car I got in or what street I walked. I was that guy from Boyzone. I was Shane Lynch from Boyzone. What's these cables you're running now?
Fuel lines.
These are fuel lines?
Yeah.
Now coming back, a lot of me wants to make amends on the past. Boyzone years, 93 to 2000.
Is that all custom made as well?
Yeah, it's been custom. And a lot of me, it's a part of my life. It's a part of who I am. In fact, it is who I am. Forget a part of. It actually is who I am.
As soon as we all, you know, wind down our individual things at the top of this year, we'll all be ready, 200% ready to make this work.
It's always in the band, you know.
Hello. I'm very well, thank you.
Not doing anything else solo for a year anyway, at least.
You know, you're in anticipation of what's going to happen, you know.
Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
No problem.
How do you feel about Mikey doing all this amazing stuff
really
on the ice?
I think one of the main questions we're all kind of being asked at the moment as well is,
Are we going to follow in his footsteps, kind of thing? But in fairness, you can only follow it if. Oh, there you go. You can only follow it if you thought you could beat it, and I don't think any of us could do a better job than what he's done. So, you know.
Plus, the footsteps he's leaving are really confusing because I like big straight lines.
We're so mad to see the five of us. We're not like any other boy band. You know, I've watched them all. I've seen. I've been involved in Westlife. I know what other bands are like. We are a heart crash. That's why it's so colourful and mad, though.
Lovely to see you again. Yeah. And if you do a tour, are you going to make it big? Are you going to go worldwide, meet all your fans from all over the world?
Or I think you want to, don't we?
Worldwide.
Yeah. I'd love to. We
want Boyzone to be even bigger than the band it was the first time round.
Oh, Jesus, we're huge at that time, Lowe. We got to go it.
You told me to lose loads of weight. I did. Now you're saying you want to be big.
That would be nice.
We still laugh now and we still, you know, we find fun in things that we do, but for me, Steve and I have this sense of humour that it's just, you know, it's just gone. It's just gone
there
now.
There seems to be a language there that only a few people know.
Yeah, and it's hard for me because it's just gone, really, you know. Steve and I, you know, me and the boys, we all have our little bubble and we all have our sense of humour, but, you know, Steve and I had another one, like another part of it, which was, it's just gone. I don't have anyone I share that with other than him. And we laughed, we belly laughed every day, you know, we were two peas in a pod, Steve and I, like that one.
And when we get into the realms of Boyzone, it's an escapism, and our energy, our bond, our commitment, everything about it is our own little world we live in. And it's always been bulletproof, and I think for the first time, that dream world and dream state has been penetrated.
The commitment that the boys in Boyzone have together is a bubble of security. We feel secure when we're together. We feel that nobody else understands our emotions, whether it's high emotions because we've succeeded in achieving something, or if it's a low emotion, you know, the worst one ever was obviously the loss of Stephen. You know, we feel the same emotions whether it's high or low, and we have each other to be able to understand that.
What we went through together and what we continue now to go through together, nobody really gets, nobody understands unless you're in the bubble, and it's a bubble.
Sorry, man, how you doing?
All right. I'm good, yeah.
Sorry,
I'm
all
right.
A big thing coming up at the beginning of March.
Yeah, did you find that losing Stephen has brought you even closer as four men?
I don't think we're out to impress anyone anymore being hard men or being any. You know, we're grown ups, we have children, we have wives, and at the end of the day, if I'm sad or something, you know, I'll cry in front of a man. I don't mind, you know. One of the reasons why on a press day we were continuously talking and reflecting back on Stephen is because we were so quiet and silent amongst the period of time when he passed. So a lot of people are still trying to get their teeth into us as four individuals and how we're feeling.
Every single one of the journalists, regardless of the type of interview they were kind of holding, all asked me about Stephen. And it would have been an easy way to go, I don't want to talk about it. But at the same time, I'm not that kind of person that want to protect myself and get other people feeling sorry for me because I've lost a friend. For me, I didn't ever want to feel that I was using Stephen's passing as an easy way out or an escape route because he's lost his life. I've lost my friend, which is heartbreaking, but he's lost his life.
It's one after the other, the same thing over and over again.
That's the focus of all the interviews. We've covered that as far as media is concerned. Everybody knows, you know.
Well, you know, this is the way things will be for the foreseeable future. You know, Stephen's passing is, you know, the focal point of the band's immediate history.
Tosta, how do you feel about it? How do you...
At different stages, different people are going to find it difficult to talk about Stephen. But you'll never have a day that the whole four of us are going to find it difficult. So on the days that people are finding it difficult, the other people just need to kind of step in and do what they can do. I knew we were going to be asked those questions again. I think it was a little bit naive maybe for people to feel that there weren't going to be those questions again. But, you know, it is what it is. And everybody, although we're dealing with this together, we're also dealing with it our own individual ways, and that's different.
I thought we were through that and that it was we're going to move forward now and try. Obviously, you can't avoid the fact that Steele's gone and we say, yeah, it felt weird this morning, you know, and we always knew it was going to be weird. And
was like straight back. So how was it at the funeral? How was it like? I mean, no, I'm not talking about that again.
Yeah. Anyway, what are we doing?
Studio one?
Yes, studio one.
Thank you.
Are we starting? Where are you at? Have you visualized the band
then? No, I thought about it. I think we just stand in a row. You know, there was different times that, so Studio and I stand in front, Mikey in the middle, Shane and Keith at either end, kind of pull back a little bit. No, I don't know if that works. I don't think you can do that anymore, so I think it's the four. We're four now. Just in a row. That's how we perform. I mean, don't try and change it.
No. Because when you do the special, you're going to have 2 days to put that together.
It's going
to
be very quick. It's going to be full on.
So you're going to send the girls in and get them all?
They're doing a few days before us. Then we go in for 2 days, work on our own, and then a day with them, I guess, and make it all work. Congratulations. The four of us today, this was the first time that we stood in the situation that we've stood so many times as a five-piece in front of a mirror getting ready for a show and getting ready for a rehearsal or a tour, whatever it may be. And this is our time when we would actually say to each other, this is, you should do that and you should do that and maybe you should do that, you know. And I felt it today. I felt today was the first real day that we, you know, we're starting to move forward. It's the performance moments that were always going to be hardest for me.
It's when you're reminded that he's not here.
And I would always look over at him as he started his vocal on the verse, and I would go into the routine and look at him, and he'd be ready, and he'd look at me, and it wasn't there. And yeah. That is just massively evident for me now.
Now, how did you all feel about walking into that room today? So my first thoughts were, Jesus, I can't handle this.
He said, I went into that room today thinking nothing had changed, because I can't go into the room and go, I have to walk into this room without Steele now. If you keep thinking that way, you constantly get knocked back. I have to go into the room thinking he's still there. It's still just as normal.
Yeah, me too. Me
and
too.
As the day unfolds, different elements and different things hit you, and it hurts.
You remember I looked at you when we had the five chairs?
I know. And
for one moment, I thought that chair was going to be left empty.
Yeah.
And that fucked nearly killed me.
Right.
And I looked over to him and
you saw the chair in the room,
yeah.
Which is Mika's going to use.
Yeah, but just for that moment, I wasn't aware of that.
No, but I walked into that room today, I was a little bit daunted by a whole situation, what was ahead of me, of a day, of getting on that learning routine, the stage, girls, moving forward without me wanting to move forward.
Yeah.
So the first thing I said was, I'm going to go for the point, lads. The first thing we wanted to do was actually leave that room. As opposed to staying there. We just sat there and had our moment. And what that gave me was a defining moment of understanding amongst our relationship of, as long as we're together, we're okay.
Yeah, I agree with you, because I think in the past, there'd be times where you go, well, you go on offer a point, I'm going to stay here and do
yeah,
it. You know?
I'll watch what's going on.
You know,
the first thing we wanted to do was
I just wanted to be with you two. I thought, wherever you're going, I'm going. I'm not staying here on my own.
When Stephen passed away, we did feel very vulnerable and open. And that's why at that time, we couldn't explain it at the time, but everything we did, we tried to do together. Because obviously, we all felt secure when we were together.
So no, he needs to... I'm buying you a BlackBerry today, right? I'm buying you a BlackBerry.
I told you, you can buy one like a phone, and all it does, your emails come through.
You just get that little icon, you open it, and you read it. That's it.
If you buy me a BlackBerry, the first thing I'm going to do is go home, and on the digital channels, and send your mobile phone in and get maybe £350. And that's what I'm going to go and do.
I'm buying you BlackBerry and you're going to have email.
I'm going to send it in.
We'll be up there in a couple of minutes, yeah. All right. Okay. All right. Couple of minutes, probably. Okay. I just throw something on this now and I just want a curveball. How do y'all feel about where we've been since Christmas?
Why come back to Boyzone? Because I enjoy it more than being on my own. I love being in the band. I want to be in Boyzone. I don't want to be on my own. I enjoy it. I love it. I want to make music with you guys.
Do you want to be with the band? Always.
Of course I do.
Oh, you're starting to ask even more questions. It was a simple question.
Oh,
and I knew he had a simple answer for it. And the answer would have been the same, that I have my own solo career going on at the minute.
He went to a different place, though. I didn't like where you went there.
Why?
Just in your whole demeanour of...
Well, no, when all the questions were thrown at me, I just didn't know what to do.
No, that's what I mean, and I don't like that, because I think we're beyond that.
Honestly, more than anything else, I just love being with you guys. I just love it. I love the crack. I love our atmosphere. I love us.
But that's it.
People together.
But that's the answer to the question.
Our biggest issue was that we were always afraid to bring things up.
I don't think we've ever spoken like this before.
No, we've never ever dealt with anything in the band.
The usual Irish way.
We always just skated over things. Always.
No pun intended.
No, yeah, I see. Yeah. So we always did.
Except for one fella.
And you know who he is.
And he's on tonight.
And Mike, you know who he is. And the thing is, I think what has happened here is that definitely our situation has brought us closer together, but also it's made us a little bit more, I don't know, a bit more like, you know what? I love you, man. And I have to tell you, I'm just...
I think we should rock.
How do y'all feel about the record?
I'm very, very proud of what we've achieved as the band we are today.
Yeah.
It's amazing. Like, seriously, it's amazing. Like, I can't wait to go home, put that album in and listen to it because I love it.
Yeah.
And that's the first time in all of the years I ever thought, I love this.
Yeah.
Be it a loss and be it me reflecting subconsciously on what I don't have now or not, I love what we've done. And I look forward every day to seeing you boys because I know I'm safe there.
Yeah.
Or I feel safe.
I feel safe.
Steel.
God bless.
Steel.
Cheers.
You know, these are probably the most important days of our lives as a band again. You know, this time we're finding our feet again and trying to find if we can survive as a four-piece.
Saturday night when people see this show, and I just worried, that's all. I'm just you know, we haven't been together and we haven't done anything, and
so how can we make sure that happens?
I don't know.
I haven't stood on a stage without Steel with the other lads with me. Any time I've been on stage with the other guys, Stephen has been there to me, to my right. So I don't know. I have no idea what it's gonna feel like. I have no idea if it's gonna work. I don't know if it's gonna look too obvious without him.
There's always a worry there that it's just not going to look right, it's not going to feel right.
Hey, can I please take that out of the bill?
Whatever you want.
I have no regrets, girl, you will be there.
Perfect. Yeah?
We bounce off each other when we're in a band. You feed off each other. You watch each other. We're not solo performers when you're on stage with the band. We work as a unit and it's special. It's really special.
There constantly seems to be another element. You think you're over the performance, the first performance, but, you know, there's another thing. And then it makes you think, what's the next thing? Is it going to be the tour? Is it going to be, you know, who knows? But it keeps hitting you.
I personally believe that there's no such thing as the last time we do anything. You can't make this film without addressing the issue of the death of our friend, because that's what we began making this film with. and we're not ending with it by all means, but it's a part of the whole story.
He's looking after us. He'll get us through this one. By God, will he?
Just because the questions end doesn't mean we've forgotten about Stephen. We'll never forget about Stephen. You know, and I'm comfortable with that now. And I'll never stop missing him, but I understand he's gone.
This is our first little prayer we saying to him, not with him.
You know, you're looking down upon us tonight. Give us your powerful performance. Give us that extra step. Help us be like you were. And help us all have a PCO on stage tonight. Anybody else want to add to that?
I beg you, Nicky.
I love his voice.
Let's help us be ourselves, and please be with us.
Friends matter, right?
Amen.
The journey of Boyzone has taken 17 years. In that time, we've become close, and where we are right now is at a matured area that you realise the fragility of life.
We're not getting any younger. So, you know, when you start getting to our age, you start to appreciate the good things in life, the finer things in life, the things that make you smile, the things that make you happy. Boyzone is something that makes me smile, it makes me happy. So I want to make sure that I don't take it for granted, that I embrace it and I enjoy every moment. If anything, that's one thing I've learned over the last 6 months, is to make sure that you enjoy today today and don't look back on it with any sorrow.
It's going to be a different future. It's a new future ahead of us. We don't know what it holds, but we're willing to accept and embrace whatever it may be. I love being a part of it now more than I ever did in the past.
Why?
Because when you're younger, you don't appreciate as much as you should the opportunities that you're presented with in life.
Well, yeah, I mean, you know what? We actually worked well together as a four-piece, which is relieving. Relief, should I say.
Relieving. Relieving who?
We worked
who do you think you're relieving?
And I felt... I felt all right.
Does this mean that we have a whole new future ahead of us now? Because it's a new album, it's a new sound, it's a whole new dimension, it's a whole new dynamic. Does this mean that we have a future again for the next 5, 6, 7 years, 17 years? Hopefully. It's a very exciting thought.
Sitting here in this leather armchair, the future is rosy, I feel. Very positive, very good, very excited. And I love being on Boyzone.
One thing we all realise with Steel Pass is forget about the small shit. Get on with life. It's so short. We realise that now. We enjoy each other's company, appreciate the time we have together. And then we're apart. We're with our families. We have our own lives. And then we get back together and we enjoy it again.
It's been a sad time for you guys and for us guys and everything, but Stephen Gately wouldn't be happy that we continue being that sad. He brought the colour into Boyzone. So from this moment on, instead of being sad because we lost Stephen, we're going to bring a bit of Stephen into it, a bit of colour into it. That's what Stephen would want. He'd want us all to smile, big smiles, and be happy and celebrate the life that Stephen Gately led. And that is what we're going to try and do from now on, is to celebrate him and not mourn him anymore. We'll always remember him, we'll always love him, he'll always be with us. But now there's a bit of Stephen in all of us, because we have to smile and be happy and celebrate that Stephen Gately was with us for 16 years.
I will learn to live before I die. Will learn to love. Try. all for the man that I used to be, till I gave it all.